How do characters move around in games? You press forward on your controller, then your character moves around the world without going through floors and walls, for the most part. When playing games, you might have wondered how the computer moves the character through the virtual environment. I've been working on an open source character controller project in Unity, and we'll go through how I implemented character movement. Character movement is a core part of many games. How a character moves can determine how the game feels. Whether it's the precise and controlled movement of platformers like Celeste, the predictable movement of shooters like Overwatch, or even the humorous movement of rolling a rock down a hill in Rock of Ages. How a character moves through a scene is important to set a tone and give a player agency while playing. We will be investigating a character design like Quake's character movement that moves with responsive and precise controls based on player input. We will be using Unity's physics engine to compute how the player moves through a 3D space and visualize this through examples. Why design my own character controller when Unity has an existing built-in character controller? My purpose in creating this character controller is to gain a greater understanding of Unity, as well as allowing for more customization in the built-in version. Hopefully you'll be able to learn a bit more about Unity and character controllers as well. When moving in a 3D environment, it is critical to ensure that the character moves how the player expects to avoid causing disorientation. To ensure that, we will start off by designing a basic camera controller to turn and pitch the camera based on mouse movement. To do this, you will first set up an input to read mouse movement. Save the current target pitch, looking up and down, and yaw, looking left and right. Each frame, we will change this pitch and yaw based on how far the player moves the mouse. We must also add a bound to the maximum a player can look up or down. We don't want them to rotate the camera around and see the world upside down. Now that we have the direction the player is looking, we can add basic motion. Set up a new input using the W, A, S, D keys for moving forward, left, backward, and right. We can convert this into a vector where 1 represents moving forward in that direction and -1 represents moving backward, with 0 for no movement. We also need to ensure that this vector stays within a circle by normalizing its length so the player won't move faster if they move diagonally. Next, we can rotate this vector by the direction the player is looking and get the direction we should move the player. We can achieve this by multiplying a rotation matrix, also called a quaternion, by the movement vector to get the rotated movement. Without this rotation, the player would always go the same direction no matter what direction the player is looking, which can be quite disorienting. Great! We now know where the player wants to move. However, this does not account for colliding with surfaces. Despite how the player looks, they are this capsule or pill-like shape when detecting collisions with the world. This pill shape is useful as it is roughly a humanoid shape and allows for sliding off angled surfaces as to not get stuck on edges like a cube would. We could make the character a dynamic physics object to allow them to bounce off surfaces with the built-in physics engine, but this can lead to an unpredictable movement that can sometimes not be ideal. For the precise motion we are trying to achieve, instead, we can make our own kinematic object that is not pushed by objects around it and compute where it should move. Unity has a function to determine if a capsule collides with any object in the scene when moving it a given direction. Using this function, we can check what the player would hit and stop them before they hit that object. The movement of the character is visualized with this debug script I wrote to show where a player would have moved had they not hit the wall. The darker blue capsule represents where the player will end up, while the lighter yellow capsule shows where the player would have overlapped with the wall. Now we can stop a character before they clip through walls. However, this means that the player will get stuck whenever they hit something and not move anymore. This will get the character stuck on surfaces and stop them from moving smoothly. To get around this, we can take the remaining motion after hitting something and have the character bounce and slide off that surface. We don't want them to bounce like a rubber ball, as that would make it difficult to move around precisely. Instead, we want to have the character slide in the same direction as the surface they hit. So if we run into a wall, we will slide along that wall. If we went into a ramp, we will slide up that ramp. We can achieve this by projecting our remaining movement onto the plane we hit using the normal vector of that surface and scaling it to retain the remaining distance we can move. During any individual movement, the player should not bounce too many times, so limiting this to 3 bounces should be sufficient. We can also decrease this remaining momentum depending on how sharp of an angle the player makes when walking into the surface. This makes walking directly into walls move slowly while only grazing a wall have little effect. This works great, but we have forgotten something critical from the character controller. Gravity. The same function we use to detect how the player hits walls can also be used to detect if we are standing on the ground. We simply need to cast the character in a downward direction and see if they are close enough to the ground. We can set a threshold of 1 centimeter. Anything closer than that, we will be on the ground. We can add a velocity to our player and increase that velocity using a gravity acceleration if the player is not standing on the ground, and set this velocity to zero when the player is on the ground. This way, the player will slowly speed up while they are not on the ground and stop once they hit the ground. Another important feature is to not bounce off the floor when moving. Just because we are on the ground does not mean that we are standing still. An 89-degree incline is technically not vertical, but that doesn't mean that we can walk up it. We can compute the angle between gravity and the surface the player is standing on, and make them start falling if it is above some maximum threshold walking angle. For the demo, this threshold is set to 60 degrees. Additionally, if the player is standing on a sloped surface, the player's movement should be rotated to move with the ground if they are not falling, so that they don't bounce off the surface as they walk down and up ramps. Just like with the bouncing from before, we need to simply project the player movement onto the surface they are standing on and correct the vector length. Putting all these concepts we've discussed earlier together, we can design a component that will move a player. This component has a defined camera angle, velocity, and gravity, and for each frame will 1. Rotate the camera based on player input, 2. Compute the desired movement of the player from camera angle and input, 3. Checking if the player is on the ground and adjusting gravity accordingly, 4. Move the player based on their current velocity and desired movement. Putting all these concepts together into one class, we get a basic character movement that interacts responsively to player input. There is an example of this basic character controller in my open source project called a simplified KCC, short for Kinematic Character Controller, if you want to investigate the source code for how this works with a simple example. The full KCC has quite a few more parameters and features that is a bit more complex for future videos. The script for visualizing and debugging character movement is in the repo as well and can be adjusted with a few different settings such as maximum number of bounces and distance the player can move. This visualization helped me to debug the player movement upstairs, an unexpectedly complex topic, and for calculating jumping. Thanks for listening to the video. I'll be making future videos on this character controller as well as other game design topics in the future. If there are any topics you're interested to learn more about, let me know what you think in the comments below. This project is open source under the MIT license. You can use it for free of charge on any project while following the license. Additionally, you can submit a code change, open an issue for an error, or submit a feature request on the GitHub page. If you add something interesting, I would love to highlight it as a future video topic. The list of the video games that were used in this video appear in the description in the order in which they appear. Thanks for watching and listening. Have a great day.